Hi crafty friends, Tanya here from Ink Responsibly, and I want to share with you a really fun and easy technique. So this is called the mother of pearl technique, and I have used it to make the butterflies in this card. So let's get started. We're going to do the technique and then I'll show you how to put the card together. So I just take a sheet of Whisper White cardstock and I grabbed some ink, so I'm starting off with Pool Party, and I'm just laying down some colour. Now you don't have to worry about getting streaks on your cardstock. We're just wanting to lay down some colour. So once I've got that, I'm going to put in a bit of a darker shade. This is Bermuda Bay. Now, if you want, you can go back and add a little bit more colour over that. Okay, so once I've got that done, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a piece of cling wrap, any brand, doesn't matter. So I'm going to take about a 12 inch piece of it, and I'm just going to crumple that up into a ball. And then what makes the magic is a pearl type pigment paint. So this is an acrylic paint and it has a pearl luster to it. So this is a white pearl paint. And on a whatever surface, you can put it on a palette or on just a scrap of paper. I'm just putting a little bit down, about the size of your thumbnail, and then I'm going to pat into it and then just dab off a little. And now I'm just going to pounce that onto my cardstock. And then dab it all around. And then we're going to let that dry. So when your panel has dried, it's going to look something like this. And look at that gorgeous shine to it. So from here we can use this as we would a regular piece of designer series paper or any pattern paper, but I'm going to take you and show you how I made my card. So I have a standard card as a tent fold, so it has a fold along the top, and from there I'm going to make a cut along here. So I'm going to place my fold line at the 2-inch mark, or 5 centimetres, and just cut that piece off. Now once I've got that, I'm going to stamp my greeting, and I'm using the Happy Birthday from Butterfly Basics. And I will grab my Stampin' Pierce mat. And I always like to hold it just a little bit longer when it's the archival ink, so I'm using the basic grey archival. It just gives it a bit more time for the ink to sink into the paper. So once I've got that done, I'm going to cut up my mother of pearl paper. So I'm going to use the coordinating thinlet dies, and I'll be right back. So once you've cut out your butterflies, simply give them a quick brush to get rid of all the leftover pieces. And if you've got any pieces that don't want to come out, just use your pokey tool. Here is my large butterfly. It's so pretty. This is such an easy technique and you get beautiful results out of it. So I've got my butterflies cut. Now I need to cut a couple of thin strips. So once I've got my butterflies, I need just a couple of thin strips. These are roughly half an inch wide. I also need a sheet of acetate, which is roughly the same size as our card front. And I need a couple of pieces of coloured cardstock. I've chosen Wisteria Wonder, which is one of the colours that we've used in here. And I have dry embossed this with the Garden Trellis embossing folder. So let's put our card together. So starting with the card front, I'm going to just lay down some fast fuse. Now from there, I'm going to place my acetate, my window sheet down. Then I'm going to put some fast fuse onto one of my embossed panels. And it's very sticky. And then I'm going to lay the embossed piece directly over the bottom of, using the back of our card as a guide. So then I can simply, because we don't want to see our glue, I simply put my other embossed piece over the top of that. And that will hide that panel. If any of the edges don't match up, that's fine. We can trim them off after. So now our pieces that we cut to roughly half an inch, I'm going to place some fast fuse on both of those. And just lay them down. And we can just turn our card over and snip off our excess. Now we still have one piece where we can see some of the workings. So same thing again, I'm going to place some fast fuse down and I just have a little strip which is just under 2 inches wide by 4 inches long. And I will pop that. Oh, it's so sticky. Just pop that over the top there. Now, if it doesn't go down the way you want it to, just grab a bone folder and smooth that out a little. Okay, so we have this. Now we're going to place our butterflies down. And I've also taken a couple of the little, it's a little flourish from the Flourish Thinlet dies. And so it's this die here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick this onto the bottom of my butterfly. Now I use my Tombow for that. So I want to have one coming out one way and one the other. I'm just going to poke that, push that down. Now for our other butterfly, so we've also die cut a smaller butterfly. I'm just going to pop a little bit of glue in the middle and place that right in the middle. And then we have our gorgeous butterfly flourish. Now to pop this down on our acetate, I'm just going to use a few glue dots. And one more. And I'm just placing it so it frames our sentiment. Right, like so. And to finish it off, I'm just going to grab a couple of our little mini pearls. And just a few on our little flourish. Last one. So there you are, a beautiful, beautiful technique that you can use as cardstock, you can use it for cutting with your framelits and any of your dies. You can stamp over the top of it. I hope you give it a try. It's a lot of fun, and I'll see you next time, guys. Stay crafty. Bye.